Good morning to everyone. The SBI, the field agents are still out working this case, but they did send us a press release, and I'm going to read the press release that everyone should have. The Dallas County, at the request of the Selma Police Chief Kendall Fulford, special agents with the Alabama Law Enforcement Agency, State Bureau of Investigation, initiated an investigation into the murder of Selma Police Officer Marquise Moore on Tuesday, July the 27th. Officer Moore was shot and killed in the early morning hours of Tuesday, July the 27th at the Selma Square Apartments in Selma. SBI special agents and other assistant investigators worked nonstop throughout the night following up on tips, leads, and interviews. Agents were able to identify a suspect, Javonte Stubbs, 18 years of age. SBI agents obtained a probable cause arrest warrant for Stubbs. In the early morning hours of Wednesday, July the 28th, 2021, Stubbs was arrested by the U.S. Marshal Gulf Coast Regional Fugitive Task Force and SBI agents near Tuscaloosa, Alabama, and formally charged with capital murder of a law enforcement officer, capital murder, shooting into an occupied dwelling, and attempted murder. Agents and officers with the Alabama Attorney General's Office, the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, Firearms, and Explosives, U.S. Marshal Service, 4th Judicial Task Force, 17th Judicial Task Force, and the Dallas County Sheriff's Office were instrumental in assisting and supporting the investigation, along with locating and apprehending the suspect. I want to thank personally from the Selma Police Department and the City of Selma all of the chiefs and law enforcement agencies that have reached out to us and showed their support and given us their prayers during this time. And I want to continue to ask for their prayers and support as we go through this difficult situation.
I echo the expressed sentiments of the chief and thanking the agencies that were involved. I also want to thank all the mayors and other public officials who have reached out and expressed their concerns and prayers for our community. I also want to continue to encourage the community to continue in prayer for the family, the Moore family, as they prepare to commemorate the life of their loved one and an officer of our community. This was done right. The City of Selma and Selma Police Department, we stepped aside. We turned this investigation over to the state, and the state stepped up and did exactly what was supposed to be done. And the consequences, within 24 hours, there was an arrest. And so now the question becomes, what's next? Well, what's next is this, now that an arrest has been made, this will go now between the state and the district attorney's office. This goes directly to the district attorney's office, and I see him present here, and not sure if he would like to join us. He may or may not, but he is here. But this goes now from the state to the district attorney's office. So you won't be hearing a lot or anything from the city because we still are at arm's length from this process. So the district attorney and the judges will be moving forward from here. I want to mention something, though, a group that has not been acknowledged in this whole process. And that group is the citizens in the community. If you notice in the statement that was released by SBI, they said tips, leads, and interviews. Those are citizens. People, the community, stepped forward and began to share information that was coming in. It was coming in swiftly. It was being calls are being made in every direction, from every direction in our community, providing tips and leads as it relates to this case. That tells me something. That tells us something. It tells us that, yes, we've had 15 murders in our community. 9 of them we have made arrest. But this tells me that when the citizens speak up, that the other six could be done in very short order. It really is important that the public, that we get engaged in this process, because when we speak what we know, it really makes a difference in bringing these cases to the district attorney's office, to court, and seek justice for our victims, for the victims in our community. And so I want to simply leave this thought. If you see it, say it. Let us know what you see, what you believe to be the case. Let the law enforcement agencies vet that information and then carry it forward as appropriate and necessary. I make one other point. If you know it, tell it. If you see it, say it. And if you know it, tell it. Let us know, because you really are, we are the citizens, we are our law enforcement arm. We are the ones who genuinely have the information that's needed to make these arrests and to resolve these cases. And so I make that strong appeal. I will restate again the crime numbers that were used on yesterday, where people were calling in and providing information, and you know where you called. If you called someone, call them again. But what you did worked, and that's 855-75-CRIME, 855-75-CRIME. Call the number, 855-752-7463. And now, having said that, I want to just reiterate the fact that this is one of the media phones. I'm not going to answer it. that's okay. I want to reiterate my sincere condolence and the condolence of the city, of the family and the friends of Officer Moore. I think we now have to go through the process of planning and preparing the memorial services and paying the due respects for an officer of the Selma Police Department. We really are sincere about our expressions of grief and sorrow, and I want the family to know that we grieve with you. Those are my comments. Note that the chief nor I are able to answer any other questions about the case. That information would have to come from the State Bureau of Investigations, Aaliyah, or from the district attorney at whatever time he actually receives this situation on his desk and as it moves forward. But I feel confident that the wheels of justice will continue to turn swiftly, and that we will be able to move this process forward. That's all I have. Thank you all for coming, and thank you for sharing this information with the public.
What about questions not pertaining to the case? Such as how long Officer Moore was an officer in the Selma Police Department? Where he's from?
I don't know. I don't know how to answer any questions. I'm just being honest with you. This is not something that I don't know how much of any of this or anything that's said. There have been some instances doing. I will say this: there have been some instances in cases like this where people speak out of turn, and you really don't know when what you say can impact or affect a case. And so when in doubt, you err on the side of caution. And in this particular situation, caution means quiet.